What's good, everyone? What is good? Welcome back to the channel with yours truly, of course, Machiavelli. I hope you all or have a great help. Yeah, today's been one of those days. Anyways, guys, what's good, everyone? What is good? Welcome back to the channel with yours truly, of course, Machiavelli. I hope you all are having a great day today. And today we are back with another speed build for you guys. So today's speed build, we are going to be... We are gonna be doing a house build, and today's gonna be sort of like a modern slash mid-century modern slash you know, mixed with a traditional style house. I don't know, it's gonna have modern in it, mainly because this whole week is build week, and it's like modern builds or whatever, but it is build week. When I say build week, I mean build week. For my Life of the Pearson series, I need a bunch of houses. So, yeah, prepare yourself for a lot of houses, pretty much, because that's all I've made for the last 2 days. I have like 4 videos and they're all houses. So, yeah, prepare for build week. It's gonna be great. Some of the builds will be like, what? Isn't like the same build, but like you just change it a bit? I know, but like... For the thing is, I'm doing, like, you know, house tours, and, like, you know how when you end up in a cookie-cutter house, the outside might look a little bit different, but, you know, it's pretty much the same thing, so that's what I'm trying to go for with this situation. So, yeah, it might be a bit cookie-cutter, but it should implement what I'm looking for, but hopefully you guys like the house as much as I do. I didn't do the interior for any of the houses, for the biggest fact that, the biggest situation that is, I don't know. I feel like if I did the interiors, it would be easier for me to pick. I want a blank canvas for these houses. I don't want me having to like build them, because I know for a fact if I do build them in, I'm gonna be able to say, oh, I like this one better than this one because of the interior style, or I'm feeling this one more. You know, I don't want that. I just want a blank canvas so I can judge everything off of the exterior and the layout, because that's pretty much what you do with builds. You don't really judge them. Well, some, depending on where you go, most of the times you judge them. Actually, most of the times you judge them on, well, depend on construction. If you're buying from new construction, and most of the time you're judging them off of a piece of paper. But if you're buying from like sorry, I have hair in my mouth. If you're buying from an already made place, then most likely you are buying a furnished house, not furnished house, but you're buying a house that's already furnished and lived in. But yeah, I want, this is some brand new construction, as you can see, so I just want to keep it new in that sense. I should have put a kitchen, but again, I felt like a kitchen again would have tipped me over. I like lights and darks all differently depending how it feels, depending on the layout, so I'd rather it just be an empty house, and yeah, they buy into that. So yeah, so enjoy yourself, because there is a lot to come. So yeah, guys, today we're going to talk about The Sims 5. I didn't talk about that last week because I forgot to. But yeah, today we're gonna talk about The Sims 5 in this bitch. Yo, because the people are telling me The Sims 5 is coming, and I have no clue if I should be happy or sad in that sense. I know that, the thing is, I know that with The Sims time frame, they normally come up with new expansion packs every 4 to 5 years or so. And I think we're coming on The Sims 4 fourth year with The Sims 4, so I can definitely see that. I thought The Sims 5 would be coming like next year, a year after that, but I realize how incomplete The Sims 4 is. And the thing is, I don't know if you guys would be wondering which is like my favorite Sims. I haven't played Sims 1 or Sims 2. I can't find Sims 1 or Sims 2 anymore. Maybe on eBay and stuff, but that's way too expensive. But out of Sims 3 and Sims 4, I have to pick, in two different options, I pick them both in that sense. For Sims 3, of course, I pick the gameplay in that sense. I love the gameplay. I just love what you could do. I know this is like one of the weirdest ones. Everyone's like, oh my god, I love Open World, but I love grocery stores, and I love how you can only, like, I'm pretty sure in The Sims 4 and Sims 3, you could have only made stuff that you can, like, buy from the grocery, that you could buy from the grocery store. I know that might be like, what? Why out of anything in the world, why that? Because, you know, it just, I love that, I love realistic stuff. I love when the game gets more realistic, and that was the biggest realistic thing you could do. You can't just buy some stuff from the kitchen, you know? You can't just go in the fridge and be like, oh, I want to make this, and then, boof, the ingredients are in the fridge. No, you have to go to the grocery store, you gotta buy the ingredients, you need to come home, and then you make it. And I feel like with The Sims 4, they took that away, and I was so pissed. I still am irking myself. I'm praying somebody makes a grocery mod, because, like, we have everything we need there. It's just the Sims users are lazy. Like, all you have, we have all, like, add in some more vegetables, add in some more stuff, add in some harvestables. Like, I feel like, hopefully, if we ever do get a farm life, where there's, like, milk, and there's where there's cows, and there's chicken, and there's all other type of, I hate saying produce because they're animals, you know? I hate mixing those two together. But, you know, there's all types of way of getting more items. I wish they could add a grocery store into the list, you know? I think that would be a great addition. And I feel like we're right there. Like, for example, even you just need, like, berries or something to make pancakes. And it'd be cool. You have blackberry pancakes. I don't know. Just a way to do that instead of having to, like, just go to the fridge and buying it. It's just such an unrealistic thing, and I think that's the biggest thing I miss from The Sims 3. Another thing is custom worlds. Lord, I love custom worlds. That was my best. I used to download y'all remember Brooklyn Heights? Oh my god, Sims 3 Brooklyn Heights, that was my place. My favorite worlds are when you have a city, you have the suburbs, you got the rich area, you got the beachy area, and then you have, like, you know, a little bit of the mix where it's, like, the country slash there's, like, little places to buy stuff. And Brooklyn Heights had everything. Like, I played that place way too many times. I played in the city area. I played in the, you know, I played everywhere in this world. Oh my god. And the building was so amazing. Yep. For all my people who've had The Sims 3 and who has built, and, like, has built, what's it called again? Who has built actual things. Like, I used to make this one house. I made this one amazing house. And I loved how, like, in The Sims 3, you could have actually, like, the building The Sims 3 was better than The Sims 4. Definitely. Just the tools and the way you could configure things were so much better. I honestly wish I could play The Sims 3 again because I miss it, but it runs terribly. That's one of my biggest downfalls of The Sims 3 is, like, the amount of corrupted files. I couldn't play it anymore. I actually at one point loved The Sims 3 more than Sims 4, and I couldn't play The Sims 4 because I was like, oh my god, it doesn't have open world, it doesn't have cars, it doesn't have the building stuff I like. But then, like, every single one of my files got corrupted. I'm like, no, I'm done with this trash. I can't do it anymore. And so I switched to Sims 4, and that was like a few months after The Sims 4 came out. Yeah, The Sims 4 came out in September. I got it in January. So yeah, I was still holding.
Ow.
Mine. Okay, anyways, back. Sorry about that. Yeah, my monk conked out and I didn't want you to hear my demon voice. So, moving on. So like I said before, with The Sims 3, there was just so much you could do in the gameplay wise, but with The Sims 4, what it completely and destroyed The Sims 3 in was one, usability. I've only had The Sims 4 conk out on me about 10 times since I've had it for the last how many years, which isn't too bad when you think about it, because I had the Sims 3 for, I got it in August, and I stopped playing with it in December. So I've had it for around 5-6 months, and it cunked out on me every single week. Like, every a few times a week. Like, if I played that file too long, when I go back the next day, it'd be corrupted. It got so annoying to the point where, like I said, I just had to get The Sims 4 because I was tired of it. So usability, The Sims 4 definitely still is the king of that. Like, I can use that Sims 4. I can use the file from the next day, literally. I can keep the file open from the next day, and I can still use it. Not amazingly, but I can still use it. I could not do that in Sims 3. If you had a file open all night the next day, you couldn't touch the game. You'd have to, like, literally close right there. When you come back, there's a good chance it'd be corrupted. So, there's always that. And secondly, also, I loved... Secondly, I just love the way it functions more, if that makes any sense. Like, for example, I don't know. What I do miss was in The Sims 3 a little bit is the, what's it called again? I don't know what it's called. It's like MC Commander mod but it's for The Sims 3, and I feel like it worked a bit better than The Sims 4 does, in that sense that, like, I could, like, there was this one where I could, like, have Sims in the house, and I wouldn't touch them, but they just automatically just start, since I had, like, Woohoo unlocked and, like, flirting unlocked, they would just flirt with each other automatically, and they'd end up woohooing. It was so much fun to do, like, older series with that mod in my game. It just makes series more fun in that sense, because you can have your Sims go wild and they do it by themselves, you know? There's a bit, I won't say they're more personality, because that's not true, but there's a bit more option for them to do stuff with that mod. So I guess it's not The Sims 3 itself, it's the mod itself. But where the Sims 4 wins is the realisticness. Oh my god, I cannot. In The Sims 3, I tried so hard to make storylines and everything, but I literally couldn't even see their face, / mouth move, / I just couldn't. The realisticness in The Sims 4 is so much better. I can actually have proper storylines. My Sims, the Sims are big upgrade. I think that's what made my Sims 4 my favorite. It's just The Sims itself. I couldn't, my biggest pet peeve with The Sims 3 is that all my Sims, I would say, look the same, but they have the same type of structure. They, like, either one looked like that, one looked like that. There was no, like, oh my god, you're different in that sense, because everybody has made a Sim that looks like somebody in the game. You know, nothing's too original. And it kind of looks, and I don't know, the skins that they have kind of looks like clay. I don't know. It just wasn't for me. It was one of my biggest pet peeves, was the way the Sims looked, and how you can, and just how their body was in proportion. I don't know. There was just no creativity when it came to building your Sims, and that's not their fault, you know. I guess they just, at the time, didn't have the technology for it. But then I know one thing that people want to say, oh my god, the color wheel. I didn't like the color wheel. The color wheel was hell for me. Like, I liked it in the sense that, yeah, I can get all these colors, but, like, god help me, every time I opened my game, I thought my game was gonna die. Every time I flip and open that color wheel, I thought everything was gone. It'd be nice to have it, of course, in The Sims 4. I'd love to see what you could do with it, because everything is so limited, and some shirts I want, you know, a nice bright pink, or a nice bright purple, or a nice bright blue, or a nice bright green, and I can't get one. And especially with the way The Sims 4 have their clothes, like, their clothes are great sometimes, like... 5% of the time they're good, and I want to use them, but they don't have the color swatches I want. I'm like, god dang, not to go out and find custom content for it. So yeah, the color wheel would definitely come in handy in designing different colors. But again, I can see where they kind of didn't keep it, just for the sense of the fabric thing. And there's all different types of CC out there, and how hard it and how difficult it would be to, like, have a way for them to recolor CC. I don't know. I can get why they had it in Sims 4. Hopefully they bring it back in Sims 5. If they don't though, I don't care. I've lived how much years without it, and I still can. So I'm not too bothered by that. But hopefully they do bring it back, because I know a lot of people missed it. And like I said, another thing in The Sims 4 is like I said, I talked about it, the CC, as the characters, and the CC is so good. Like, I love realistic things, and the CC in The Sims 4 is just... is beautiful. So right now, what's actually making The Sims 4 win is storyline and what's it called again? I will say one is more realistic builds. Like, it's easier to build a realistic house in The Sims 4 than a Sims 3, and it looks better too. So the graphics, the Sims, and the realism is winning for The Sims 3. I mean, Sims 4, and for the Sims 3, the gameplay, there you go, the gameplay is winning, and yeah, the activities are better, the expansion packs are better, and yeah, that's pretty much it. One thing I'm happy that we don't have, I did love it, but I loved and hated it, was like, you guys remember, like, The Sims? You know how we have The Sims Resource? There's this other thing where it's called The Sims something, I don't know what it is, where you can go, you can upload your Sims there, and upload your houses there. But I feel like some people are some bioshes, and they know that they have corrupted CC, and so they'll put it in one of their Sims' outfits, and, like, you download a bunch of Sims to get their CC, and then, boof, you have the corrupted CC in your game, and then you don't know how to get it out. I hated those times. I hated them so much. Like, when you had, like the five-arm disgusting baby, you know, those demented babies with the high boots on, with, like, oh god, the corruption. I can't even. But yeah, that was disgusting. But yeah, that's just my throughout and through it's and that. So if they took all the positives of The Sims 4 and all the positives of The Sims 3 and put it together and made Sims 5, I'd be one big happy camper. I think that's my gloriness. So if they added, like I said, everything that I talked about today that I loved, and they put that in The Sims 4, 5, that game would be, like, ultimate. I highly doubt it's gonna happen. For open world, I think that's another positive. I love open world, forever will. Even if they can't build, like, an open world in the sense that everything in the world can be open, can they at least do open world neighborhoods at least? Like, I'm tired of wanting to go visit my neighbors and having to go through loading screens. Like, no. Can they change that, please? Like, I wish they added that into this. Like, even if it's not the whole world's open world, like, at least make the communities open world. Like, there's sometimes where I end up going to the wrong store and I don't want to jump into a loading screen. So, like, if it could be, like, you open, like, it'd just be great if, like, there was, like, community open worlds. I feel like that would be better than just not having it. I think I actually like that better than a big open world, because in all honesty, though, to get to, like, the bigger city, you have to travel, so that makes sense. But, like, if you wanna get to your neighbors, you don't need to travel a whole loading screen, you know? So I understand the big worlds. Another thing that I also quite love is how you can travel to different worlds and your game doesn't restart. You know, when you have to travel to a different world, like, you have to lose everything and lose all your, like, contacts, and it's just annoying. I'm so happy you don't have to do that in Sims 4. Like, yeah, it adds some realism, because, like, if you're moving across the country, a lot of things get left behind, but still, it's nice not to lose a relationship just because you want to move to a different city. But anyways, guys, that's it for this build. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hopefully you guys did enjoy, and I'll see you guys in the flip side. As always, I'm out. This is peace. Bye, guys.